So back in the 90s when you were here, mm-hmm. I'm sorry, in the early 2000s,
yeah,
when you were here, Christmas wasn't a huge thing here, was it?
No, it didn't start off that way.
Mm-mm. No, but now almost every show...
Have to have Ozark Mountain Christmas.
Yes. And we start like in
October 31st, or sometimes earlier.
Yeah, well, rehearsals, you're starting
in August.
I joke all the time. I say to our audience, come back at the end of this month at Christmas because you'll be seeing our Easter show.
That's right.
Yeah, because it's like 3 months out.
It is.
You know, we're always 3 or 4 months out.
It is.
But it's changed a lot. I mean, now you have to have two different shows, which is kind of cool because you can get some of the same people to come back.
Right.
You know, see both shows.
When we had the 30 shows in town, it's great. And then entertainers would come in going, oh, this is where you need to be. Mm-hmm. Thus, we have the 130 shows in town.
Right.
And the pie is divided way too many ways.
Yeah.
And that's where our downfall went with the rest of the shows that have been here for years.
Right.
You know, I mean, there's still the same amount of people coming. There's still 10 million people that come to visit. But, oh, look at all the choices.
Now you got to divide it up.
Yeah.
And Branson's changed a lot in the last 3 or 4 years in that now we've become more geared. We have more options for younger families.
Right.
Because there's the zip lines.
Sure.
There's all that sort of thing going on. Mm-hmm. We got the amusement parks and the water rides. And so the whole family can come.
Right.
But
they don't see as many shows.
They don't see as many shows. Mm-hmm. And along that line, there's a weird thing about Branson, I think, where if something unique opens within a year, there's three of them.
Right.
Or four of them.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. And that bothers me really bad, you know? Mm-hmm. I was excited when they opened a zip line because I'm working on cruise ships.
Sure.
I do the zip line in Haiti. There's one at Labadee that I go to. So I would always do it. And I thought, oh, good. I'm going to have a zip line. Mm-hmm. I can show my daughter how fun it is.
Right.
And so one opened. And now we have, what, four? Five?
Four or five, yeah.
Yeah. And same thing with go-kart tracks. Mm-hmm. And so they take that pie.
Yes.
And they don't think about it.
No,
they think,
they don't.
Oh, they're successful. Mm-hmm. Well, now you're splitting the same audience.
You're right.
The same clientele.
Yeah. Welcome to Branson.
Yeah. You know, it kind
of... And it's a great place. It
is
really
a great place. But sometimes, I'll be honest, there's a lot of ideas I'll come up with. Mm-hmm. And I think, maybe I should save that and do it when I'm on the road. You know?
Yeah.
Because I don't want five other people doing it.
I agree.
I want to be unique.
And that's hard because, you know, starting our show, our ideas, I see all over town.
Yeah, I know.
And that's, it's sad, but at the same time, it's kind of nice that they
sort
think
of
you.
Until you have to pay the bills and stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, I love that. Oh, they're doing it now.
See,
well,
I don't agree with that. Imitation
I don't
is
either.
The sincerest form. I hate it when people say
I
that.
I know.
Because, no, it's theft when people take things.
Plagiarism. And
it's yeah, it is.
It is.
And when you come up with a unique idea, it just really stinks, actually.
It does.
Yeah, it's very
But at the same time, you know, they're trying to keep it fresh just like everybody else
is. It is. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, you have to put things in your show, I'm sure, that work for a Branson audience.
Exactly.
And so you feel like you're doing what other people are doing. You have to have a patriotic number,
Absolutely.
Which you want to have.
Sure.
You know, we want to honor
big on country here.
The vets.
Absolutely.
Because,
and gospel.
Yeah, gospel.
Huge.
And
mm-hmm.
And if you don't have those... Mm-hmm. You hear about it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
That was one of the problems I think Darren had was Darren brought his Vegas show and he did numbers that were gospel-ish because he sang and did magic, but he didn't per se do like a patriotic flag and all this. And he would get a lot of criticism about that because you didn't follow the Branson formula.
Right.
As it's
yeah, it is the Branson formula.
But you know, you do
you
it in
it
your
work
unique
for yourself.
Way.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you guys certainly
you try
have been
to
making
reinvent it.
So the movie, would you say that you've had much benefit from that? Do people have people seen it? I mean, it was an independent film. I had to search to find it.
Right. Yeah. I've had a lot of friends from past years come out of the woodwork that have seen it. Especially since you put it on Facebook or something of that nature.
Right.
Or, hey, I saw you and I haven't heard from them in 25 years.
Yeah,
you know, it's like, oh, really? I didn't know you went through that. I know.
Yeah.
So I don't know if we've benefited from it much, but I've come in contact with people I haven't heard from in years because
of it. Do you mention
it
or anything in your show? Do you say you guys were on that?
We don't.
Think about that.
Yeah.
But maybe just the title.
I know.
Maybe you don't want to say we were part of a movie about Branson called We Always Lie to Strangers.
Well,
like it just.
But then if you explain it, it might be.
Yeah, but you don't have that. You know how people are.
I know.
You know.
I know.